Hi and welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. You know we're having council elections coming up on the 22nd of October, so I've invited a couple of local identities, one who was in council many years ago and making a comeback, and the other one who's coming in to be the voice, a new voice for the Glenira Council. And from the city of Port Phillip, I have with us ex-mayor Dick Gross.
Hi, Henry.
Hi, Dick. Welcome back to The Shtick. Yeah, I know. I had you on the show. We did an interview with you in the front yard many years ago.
It was gorgeous.
It was great to have you as an eccentric, really colourful character, which you still are in a way.
Oh, thanks very much. Although I like to see myself as more reserved, deep thinking and profound, but
What happens when you get older. I think we mature and become a little bit more conservative.
That's right. That's right. But, yeah. As you can see, I'm still a little bit pink.
And you still look great.
Oh, aren't you lovely?
Yeah. Are you ready for a comeback?
Well, look, time will tell. There's an election on the 22nd because it's of Shabbos. Obviously, many of the community will be voting beforehand or by postal vote.
Mm.
So, it's going to be interesting to see how it goes. I'm hopeful, but one can never know these things. It's a bit of a lottery. The fires of democracy do not burn very brightly at local government level. You know, people don't care that much about local government and they only focus sort of at the last minute just before the election. And so we actually don't know who's going to be thrown up by the electoral process.
And the people running aren't politicians as such.
Well, some of them are baby politicians, some of them are pretend politicians, some of them are barking mad. But, it's always a diverse and interesting array of candidates.
Yeah, there are lots of boards around all over. When you drive through the city of Port Phillip or Glenira, there are just boards up everywhere with people's names on them.
Okay, so there's two different systems. In Port Phillip, it's an attendance voting. In Glenira, it's all about postal voting. And the way the competition seems to be running in Glenira is war by boards. There's boards absolutely everywhere, and that's the way the individual candidates are trying to mark themselves out. Whereas in Port Phillip, it's more about social media, some signage, and door knocking.
Mm. And your policies, do you have anything that you're going to be standing on that's, I can see that you've got this kind of thing saying it's going to be fairer, safer and greener. They're your platform.
Okay, so I'm running in a ward called Canal Ward, which includes East St Kilda and it also includes Elwood.
Mm-hmm.
So a big part of the conversation in Elwood is the flooding. So there's been an expert committee that's done a report, the Water Sensitive Cities CRC, and my big idea is to get that anti-flooding, flood mitigation ideas can't be controlled by Port Phillip because the important assets are owned by Melbourne Water or Parks Victoria. So the role of the council in this situation is not necessarily saving the situation, but getting others, advocacy to get others to save the situation.
It's a bit like Ackland Street, for example. This is the most recent controversy.
Okay.
I walked past there the other day and it's just like all grilled fencing and the paths are all over the place. You can't walk down Ackland Street. And it was out of the council's control in some ways.
In some ways, no.
Yeah.
I would say that was... So that the Ackland Street idea has a long and venerable history. And what essentially happened was a decade ago when I was on council, we trialled closing Ackland Street. And it was extraordinarily unpopular with some traders, but welcomed by the community. So how do you balance those issues? Well, I haven't been on council, I'm not to blame for Ackland Street, but I did support it because Ackland Street could do with a different vibe. But if it's a failure, I say it's only concrete and concrete can be ripped up. So this was a joint project between the trams and the city. So there's controversy.
Which city? You mean the city of Port Phillip?
Yeah. So I don't know if any of the viewers have been down there. It's a complete dog's breakfast at the moment. It's impossible to judge it on its current state because it's still being built.
But it's also impossible to park in Ackland Street anymore now.
That's right.
The other thing I wanted to discuss was when you were mayor or you were on the council from, we didn't mention that yet, from 1996 till 2008.
So I was on council for 12 years from 1996.
There was a real controversy. The biggest thing that ever happened is the St Kilda Triangle, which was the cause of your demise in a sense.
That's right. So I was.
And nothing's happened since.
That is also correct. So we came up with a program for the Triangle and approved it. It was very unpopular and we were all chucked off.
There was a big outcry from the public.
Big outcry. Mm-hmm. And, you know, maybe we could be accused of not listening. So what happened in the interim is that millions and millions of dollars have been poured down the toilet paying for the developer to go away, paying for senior counsel in court cases that the council lost, running ridiculous planning processes that have come up with zero. So a decade on,
nothing's
it's still
happened.
A car park, yeah. Nothing's happened, and even the incumbents are still lying about how big and bad and awful the old proposal was. So I say that my proposal is dead, and I don't seek to defend it or resuscitate it, but I do seek to say, look, buckets of ratepayers' dollars have been poured down the toilet pursuing a completely sham proposal. It's the current proposal is a $350 million proposal with
no budget, no money,
and no possibility of money because there's no enterprises that have been sanctioned to cover that amount of money. So it's a dead duck.
Yeah.
So they've also lost $2 million per year rates that they would have collected on it. So in the 8 years that
that's gone... That's $20 million just lost up in smoke.
Up in smoke.
Talking about up in smoke, we've got to disappear.
Oh, already?
Already, yeah.
I feel like we've only just started.
I know. We have to get you back on after the elections to talk a bit more because there's so many issues we want to talk about. Like,
look, I'm happy to come back. And if I lose, it'll be therapy time. You know that.
We'll get a couch in the studio.
Yeah. And you'll have to be really nice. No probing questions. Nothing other than love and adoration.
Love and admiration for you, Dick. Good luck with the election.
Thanks very much.
The city of Port Phillip. And we're coming back with Ian Fayman, who's going to be running as the voice of the community for the city of Glen Eira after the break.